Hi, welcome back to the show. As promised, let's get a couple of more guests in to tell us how to approach this morning. Amit Trivedi joins us on the Futures and Options side, and we have Amrish Baliga of Edelweiss also with us to talk about the fundamentals. Gentlemen, good morning to both of you. Amrish, first a word from your end. Most people on the street were waiting for this kind of a dip to buy into the market. Would you use this, the six-day dip that we've seen, to get into any stocks? And if yes, which ones would they be?
No, today, in fact, is quite crucial because I was saying that 6,000-6,050 is a good support band, and the way things are, the way SGX Nifty is showing, clearly will open lower than that. We need to see whether it stabilizes at those levels and bounces back. So I think it's just wait and watch for today. But in case we see the markets stabilizing at these levels, surely I think it's the time to again get back into those banks, capital goods and metals.
Okay. Hi, Ambarish. Some numbers that came in after close yesterday, especially a number like Tata Global, it's just reiterating what Jubilant told us, that consumption is not picking up at all. Any thoughts on these consumption stocks?
No, this is in fact what I've been saying for a while, that consumption is slowing down, especially in tier 1 cities. We have consumption going up to a certain extent in rural areas and tier 2, tier 3 cities. But I think what drives the margins is actually the tier 1 cities. So with the consumption really going down, I think over the next 2 or 3 quarters, you'll see a major slowdown as far as these FMCG stocks are concerned.
Okay. Would there be any of the stocks reacting to those inflation numbers? Do you expect, would you go into this market shorting banks or finance companies?
Not really, because I think they have already corrected to a large extent, and there was an expectation that the inflation numbers will be ugly, what we are discussing a few days back, although it was worse than what was expected. But then I think that will priced in with a sort of a correction which we'll, which we'll see this morning. It will open with a small gap of about 30-35 points. So I don't think people will really get an opportunity to really short.
Mm-hmm. All right. Amit Trivedi also joins in to our conversation. Amit, has this market reached that oversold territory where there are no fresh shorting positions, or do you think despite the fall we can still take a fresh short position today?
Hi, good morning. Yeah, what we are seeing is, if you look at the basic background because of which the markets have been correcting, it is you have yields at around 9%, currency volatility is back in play, you have dollar 10-year bond yields at around 2.75%. So all these, like yesterday, Indonesia raised interest rates to around by around 25 basis points. If you look at all these things, the macro setup is quite bad, and there is no point fighting volatility at this point of time. While markets have corrected around 5% from 6350 levels, there is some more scope of going down. So rather than trading by selling futures or anything, you can go and do a ladder put strategy, which is buy 6000 puts and sell 5958 strike put options per se. So your maximum investment is 10 rupees in this trade, and if market falls from here on, your 6000 put will become active and you'll start making money.
Okay, stay on, guys. We'll just come back to you guys in a bit. Before that, let's get our colleagues in now to tell us what are the stocks that you should watch out for as you enter trade today. Reema joins us with the stocks in the news, and Pragya, as always, will detail all the brokerage views for us. Reema?
Thanks for that, Sonia. Watch out for IOB. The bank will be raising 1,626 crore via the government and LIC. And additionally, they will also be issuing close to 2,500 crore of perpetual bonds, either domestically or overseas. Watch for Bata India. That stock was up close to about 4% in a block deal yesterday. The promoters acquired 6.1 lakh shares, or 0.9% of the stake. In earnings reaction, Reliance Communication, the reported numbers are boosted by a provision write-back of 441 crore. But even excluding that, the margins and the profitability has actually beaten street estimates. For Build, the total income looks quite smart with a growth of about 10%, but margins are a bit disappointing and profits have declined by 49%. And Tata Global Beverages, overall fairly weak. Margins have declined by 50 basis points. Profits are boosted by an exceptional gain of 92 crore on account of sale of surplus properties in Bangalore. With that, Pragya, it's over to you.
Well, thanks a lot for that, Reema. Mixed bag today also on the brokerages. Bank of America Merrill Lynch, big upgrade on Godrej Consumer. They've upgraded the stock to buy, 25% upside from the current levels with a target price of 1100. They believe that the earnings growth will likely pick up now that the phase of high ad spends is over in the stock. The company is attractively positioned, especially in categories which are underpenetrated in the emerging market segments like household insecticides. And the current market price, they believe, does not factor in any benefits from the scaling up of the new launches which are lined up. CLSA has a sell on Hindalco, target price 95. The standalone EBITDA was 18% below their estimates, mainly because of the weak performance of the aluminium business. They expect the Indian aluminium business to continue to remain under pressure because of the ramp up in the new smelter capacity, which will be lagging behind because of the unavailability of captive coal. Post the 30% run up in the last 3 months in the stock price, they believe that the valuations are expensive at about 7 times on an EV EBITDA basis 1 year forward. Deutsche Bank has a sell on Canara Bank. They've upped their target price by 24%, mainly to account for a better than expected earnings in quarter two. They've also raised their FY14 and FY15 earnings estimate by about 22 and 16%. However, they believe that the concerns remain on the long-term business strategy of the company. The bank is growing at an extremely fast rate with a larger portfolio of loan growth is skewed towards power and infrastructure sectors. And they believe that the margins will decline going forward as the bank continues to grow at this aggressive pace. Nomura has a neutral on Reliance Communication, target price 112. The operating trends were very encouraging in the quarter two results, but they believe that the restating and the rejigging of the lines that the company is doing may not actually improve the confidence or the appeal of the stock. There is negligible contribution that will come in from collaborative deals with Reliance Infra, wherein the company plans to book the revenues only in FY15, not before that. Thank you.
All right. Thanks a lot for that, Pragya. You're noticing the difference, isn't it? In October, we had more of buy calls and overweight calls from Pragya, and now she's reading out more neutrals and underweights.
Yeah.
I guess the latter half of the results and the mood of the markets is colouring views as well. We have one more guest joining us. Parag Thakkar, the head of sales at HDFC Securities, is also joining into this conversation. Good morning, Parag. Well, just to look at the numbers that came in late yesterday after market hours, what's the call on, say, an NCC or a Tata Global? Would you outright recommend sells on these stocks?
No, I have not taken a closer look at these numbers. But overall, on a broad parameters, I think, with inflation at 10% and bond yield at 9%, and I think bond yield are at 9% due to the expectation that inflation was going to come negative. So I think the near-term outlook remains very sluggish for the markets.
What's your sense of today's market itself, Parag? What's the view at HDFC Securities? Will you all look at that inflation and IIP number negatively and see a fairly deep cut in the market? What are you advising traders?
So basically what we are saying is that, we have selected few names which are quite resilient in terms of because of very low leverage on their balance sheets across the sectors. And that is where we are pushing that, on any decline you should keep on accumulating this kind of stuff. And we are slightly defensive in our recommendations. We like FMCG companies like ITC, Dabur, Pidilite. We like Infosys. We like Mahindra and Mahindra. And we like Reliance.
Okay, so those are the top stock calls over there. Ambarish, the big number to watch out for today is SBI. And there are some analysts who are concerned about, the change of guard actually bringing in a quarter of kitchen sinking. In fact, the current chairperson, Arundhati Bhattacharya, has mentioned that, asset quality is still a concern for the bank. What are your expectations in terms of both asset quality and what the bank can deliver today?
Normally, cleaning up process happens when the top man changes, and that's what possibly could happen in case of SBI. Asset quality clearly is a issue there, and I don't know whether it'll come out this time or whether it'll come out in the next quarter or March. But then I think that's one area of concern, no doubt. But in case, the results are per market expectations, you can surely expect a bump up.
Okay. A couple of other numbers that came out post-market as yesterday, I'm going to give you the list of them, Ambarish. Are there any stocks that catch your attention? Mostly they've been on the downside. There's Bajaj Hindustan, Nagarjun Construction, Lovable Lingerie, GMR Infra, Everest Canto. A lot of them have actually disappointed the street on the operational performance. If they move lower, are there any stocks that you would buy on a dip?
Not really. I don't think any of these stocks, other than possibly JMR Infra, where in case we see levels of sub 20 again, I think we had an extremely good move from that 12, 13 levels to about 23. From there, we have seen a small correction. So in case we see levels of below 20, maybe closer to 18, I think at those levels, one could look at buying from a medium-term perspective.
Okay, Amit, you have a strategy on SBI before the numbers come out, right? Take us through that.
Yeah, so SBI currently around close to 1700, around 10:30, 11 o'clock, if the stock is stabilizing over there, we would like to sell straddle of 1700 strike at closer to 125, 130 rupees. It is trading at an implied vol of 46%. And after results, historically SBI has moved between 3 to 5%, and the vols have come down to 42 or 41% kind of things. So the straddle price of 125 should come down to around 105 rupees just after numbers or tomorrow. So that's a trade one can do.
Okay, the other big stock in the Nifty which is coming out with numbers is Tata Steel. Ambarish, what are you all going with on Tata Steel?
No, Tata Steel, in fact, I've been quite positive on that stock for a while, saying that the cycle has turned around and possibly the results could actually surprise on the upside. So, in fact, even at these levels, we are quite bullish.
Parag, from the entire earnings season, what have your top hits and top misses been?
So, basically, this earning has actually panned out slightly better than the expectations. For example, Maruti was a clear case where actually margin trajectory seems to be changing structurally. Mm. So today, let us see Mahindra and Mahindra's numbers. So in auto, I was positively surprised. In cement, it was expected to be a washout quarter. So cement, I would not look deep into it. And IT has performed in line with the expectations.
All right, I think we have to take a break at this point. We have to come back and it will be time for the pre-opening rates, and maybe we'll be able to get some more advice from our experts. Back in the jiffy.
MCX Stock Exchange, India's new stock exchange, presents Bazaar Morning Call.
Welcome back. We have about a minute for the pre-market rates to come in. So quickly, let me squeeze in with Ambarish on Coal India. Seven Nifty stocks announcing numbers. I really don't know which to ask, but Coal India, would you go positive?
Coal India, in fact, because of the possibility of a follow-on offer, I think even at these levels, there could be some pressure. And I don't think results will really play too much of a part in deciding which way it moves.
Okay, there is M&M and ONGC also coming out with numbers, so several
big day
big
today
stocks, yeah. But M&M, I think, will be a disappointment despite the good tractor numbers.
Yeah, it will actually. Very sluggish, muted performance, because the tractor sales are good, but that's been offset by the depreciation that we've seen in the auto sales. And auto sales are quite sluggish. Their UV segment has slowed down by 25%. So I guess you'll see that play out. And this time around as well, the overall proportion of tractors as a total of the volumes has gone down slightly. So the product mix has also worsened. So margins on a quarter-on-quarter basis we'll see a bit of a decline. But 20 more seconds to go. We wait by more closely for what the rupee opening will be. Remember yesterday that CPI data, inflation number at double digits, does not bode well
allied currencies
market.
Are not done too badly.
Okay.
Asian emerging market currencies, even the Brazilian real yesterday, have not seen too much of a... Yeah, they're actually stabilized. So perhaps that's why the dealers whom I polled said 63, 70, 80 is the likely opening. Like yesterday's close, but those are the pre-opening rates for the stock markets that is coming in below the 6,000 mark. That's not a surprise. That's what the Nifty indicated. But the Sensex is bravely chugging on with a mild green, 0.2% higher. That's a little bit of a surprise. I mean, these rates are bizarre. Oh, they are really terribly bizarre. I wonder if I should even read them out. Let me see if refreshing these rates is going to help. Okay, we've got Gale with a minus 14%, Asian Paints a minus 20%. I mean, this is like seriously bad numbers. Okay, I'm sorry, I think I'm reading the bigger change in the absolute numbers. In percentage terms, Sun TV is reporting a minus 4%. Gale is now 3.5%. HCL Tech is 3.5% again. Bharti Infra is about 2.7% down. JSPL down 2.5%. M&M down 2.25%. I guess these are really bizarre.
I think ITC we should follow the rate 7.7 on the rupee, Lata, because it's opened at about 63.90 right now.
It's just
about
there's a bit of a
weakness, but it's a weakness nevertheless. I mean, 2 month lows what the rupee is trading at. So that's the first opening. You'll wait by for the bond market, and you know, like you're saying, it's really some random rates that you're seeing. I guess the Sensex rates are more believable because that's a bit of a gain, up about 0.2%. But important to see how many of these frontliner stocks are moving ahead of their numbers. So SBI, ONGC, etc.
You should also wait up for the bond numbers. The bond deals don't happen at 9, but those also will have to be watched for. My sense is that they closed at 9.05 yesterday. A 9.15 cannot be ruled out, at least in opening trades, and thereafter perhaps some adjustment. The rupee is stabilizing somewhat, but we will have to wait and see what happens even on the rupee front. It's not mayhem, at least not in the opening, but let's wait and see. This would still be very, very early days for the currency, down by about 15 buys from yesterday's close. 63.70 was seen yesterday as technically important.
There was some talk of RBI intervention. Did you hear that?
That was widespread talk yesterday and even in previous occasions. 63.70 was the level sought to be defended, was at least what some people were saying. But it ended at 63.72. Mm-hmm. So that was given up at the end. You know, they didn't take it below 63.70. So today really the flanks are open for attack on the currency. But at this point in time, it's not showing so much weakness. To be fair, other emerging market currencies also did not show too much by way of cuts. So perhaps the rupee will be spared the blushes, at least in opening trade. It has been so far. Okay, that's the opening rates. Amit, any specific stock in which you have a strategy?
So we have a strategy in Tata Steel, 350 strike. Results expected. So what you can do is the vols are quite high at around 47%. You can sell the call and put of 350 strike at around 27 rupees. Tata Steel moves anywhere between 2 to 4% typically in the last few quarters we have observed. So this value of 27 should come down to around 22. So one can sell the 350 strike straddle for a target of 22 rupees in this trade.
All right. Sun Pharma may be the top gainer today because of the positive taro numbers. So Sun Pharma is up 1.5%, and Coal India as well, ahead of its numbers, is up in the green. Ambarish, when we started off this discussion, your first comment was if the markets move to that 6,000 level, then you'll look to accumulate some of the banking names. We've seen some, almost 10-15% cuts this month on names like Axis, Bank of Baroda, ICICI, etc. If you had to pick out two or three banking stocks to buy, which ones would they be?
We would pick up HDFC, Axis at these levels, and among the smaller ones, we would look at Federal, DCB, and Karnataka Bank.
Okay, what would you do with an L&T or a Reliance? We are given to understand that they are pretty close to the 200-day moving average, Ambarish. Any views on those stocks?
In fact, both of them have been buys for us, and in case we see a dip further from here, although I don't see a major dip, but if the market continues to be weak and we see a small correction in both Reliance and L&T, I think I'll utilize that as an opportunity to buy.
Okay, and finally M&M, what would you do with that stock?
In fact, we have been suggesting our clients that one should shift to a certain extent from M&M to Maruti, where in fact we see the performance to be much better over the next 6 to 9 months.
Okay, that's the opening on the bond market, by the way. So 9.12 continues to remain at really elevated levels.
So that was expected. I mean, yeah. Where will the bond traders reflect their disappointment over the CPI number? It would come first in the opening rates of the 10-year bond. Actually, we have an expert with us, Ashutosh Raina, head of FX trading at HDFC Bank, is joining in. Ashutosh, how is the market reading the CPI number, or for that matter, even the IIP number? Do you expect further losses on the rupee, or are emerging market currencies showing some stability today?
No, I don't think so. The opening clearly depicts that there is some weakness in the currency. And I think the weakening bias should continue for some more time with the dollar strength at work at the moment. So we should expect some more weakening in all emerging market currencies and including the rupee.
Is there any level you are looking at, any technical supports or levels where exporters would come in and offer?
I don't think exporters will be selling at these levels because there's a clear uptrend at the moment with clear indication of the currency to weaken with the US taper in sight and expectations of an early taper happening in December itself. We can expect better levels for exporters to sell. So I think these levels will be temporary and we should move, we should weaken from these levels going ahead.
Ashutosh, hi, good morning. What's happening in the markets? I mean, is the dollar demand from OMC still very high? And are you expecting to see any kind of intervention from the Reserve Bank today, similar to what we saw yesterday?
I think there has been intervention at regular intervals and sustained intervention has been happening continuously. So we should expect the intervention to continue. And with the flows already having come in through the measures that RBI had announced, I think RBI is in a better position to intervene efficiently now with a lot more dollars in its kitty.
Ashutosh, are you also tracking bond markets? Any views on the 10-year bond? Do you think it finds a roof, the yield at 9.12, 9.13?
With the yesterday's CPI number, I think we can expect as one more rate hike in the December policy. So we can see some weakness in the bonds, maybe not up to 9.10, 9.20, 12 levels, but definitely from the current levels, we can see some weakness going ahead.
Just one final question from my end. With the way the rupee has been moving in the last couple of days, are you getting a sense that it could head back to those August lows of around 68 or so? Or is there a floor at around the 64, 65 level?
I think 65 should be a level we should look for. Don't think 68 is a possibility considering. If we have big outflows, then maybe quite possible. But at the current, I don't think 68 looks a reality at the moment.
So really, who is buying? Is it importers who are buying or is it FIIs buying, hedges? Who are the guys putting this pressure on the currency?
I think it's an all-round demand with the oil also returning to the markets and some demand coming from there also and other import demand and other oil private oil companies also in the market. Plus lack of supplies for the last couple of days from the FIIs, which was there in the last 10-15 days, which was consistently there in the last 10-15 days, which has dried up maybe in the last couple of days. And we can see the pressure, which is imminent, and we have moved from 61, 62 levels to 63, now 64.
Fair enough. Thanks a lot. Thank you, Ashutosh, for joining us with your early morning thoughts on the currency. Weakness to continue is the word from the expert. Okay, let's shift focus back to the capital markets. We spoke with Nilesh Shah and Dharmesh Mehta as well, the guys who are spearheading the Axis Capital Investor Conference. And here's how they are reading the mood on some of the sectors that they have chosen.
There are long-term investors who take a five-year view. For them, actually, this kind of sell-offs are the big opportunities wherein they can buy into this kind of dips. Because long-term, once these elections are over and whatever global fears go down, this will become the most investable destination. Hopefully, if we get a good government and policies are back in action. So for them, this is like opportunity of the lifetime for them to invest in. While some of the other players might take some short-term correction as profits and start booking it now or try to come during that time and time the market. But it's very tough to say, especially when these events are unpredictable.
Within IT and pharma, one can be stock specific and probably mid-cap IT companies could provide a great opportunity. And we have already seen a couple of mid-cap IT companies running up 100-200% in the last couple of months. More importantly, what market is not yet discounted, but which could be a money spinner opportunity is the import substitution theme. Clearly, when rupee was overvalued, there was a pressure of imports on the Indian manufacturing sector. But now with the rupee depreciation, not only you can manufacture to meet local demand, but also you can act as export hub. And this import substitution is one sector in Indian manufacturing space where hope has come back. The orders are not yet there. But eventually, if things pan out, we will probably see a much better opportunities in the import substitution theme. Our overweight position will be always in private sector bank and NBFC vis-a-vis public sector bank, because historically, if we see, they have delivered better return. They have delivered better return because of the way the environment is. From a trading point of view, certainly certain PSU banks, and some of them we are showcasing in our conference, does deserve an investment purely because the market is factoring too much of bad news into it.
Okay, that's the Axis Capital view. Largely positive, actually, believe that the bad news, at least on the economy, is at an end. But the pre-market rates have kind of settled, and it looks like the Nifty is likely to open just a little south of the 6,000 mark. 5,998 is where we have ended the pre-market rates, and then Sensex as well, falling by about 0.15, not a great deal. Mid-caps could be about 0.25% lower, so they may underperform the heavies, as at least as far as the pre-market rates are concerned. The rupee and the bond rates should also be kept in mind. The rupee, after opening with about a 17 pice cut, is now stabilized a wee bit. It's still a cut, but it's like more 15 pice. The cut is reducing somewhat. As well, the bond yields opened at 9.13 and now at 9.09. So the gap down opening in bonds appear to be bought into. At least some bit of shortcoming has clearly happened. Let's invite our main guest for the morning, Manishire Chaudhary of BNP Paribas Securities joins in. Good morning, Manishi. Good to have you at what may be a crucial day.